do any of you find it really hard to keep your bottom in the saddle when you're riding? So today I want to give you some tips to help you improve your seat as you horseback ride. And as always, before we get started, make sure you like this video and subscribe to our channel for more weekly horse videos. And I'm also thinking of a future video I want to do, just answering some controversial horse questions that are out there. So why don't you comment below any controversial question that you may be hearing and you want to know the answer to. Okay, so how to improve your seat on a horse. What does that mean, first of all? So your seat is basically how you sit on your horse. Like, are you able to keep your bottom in the saddle, or do you sometimes bounce around uncontrollably and you don't know what to do to stop that? So today I'm gonna share how you can keep your bottom in the saddle more effectively and also have that connection with the horse, so you're also using your seat to drive the horse and communicate with the horse as well. So my first point is a really simple one that you can try, and it's an easy fix, and it's simply keeping your shoulders back. So keeping your shoulders back is just part of correct posture as you ride your horse and as you do everything else in the world. And the reason keeping your shoulders back isn't important when it comes to your seat and horseback riding is because your shoulders can help center your balance. So if you have your shoulders back, you're sitting up, your center of the balance is over your horse. And if you look at it from the side, your center of balance will be directly straight through the saddle and straight through the barrel of the horse. So that means you're centered over the horse and you're gonna be much more balanced compared to if your shoulders are forward, which then throws your weight and your balance over the front of your horse, so over their shoulders. And when you do that, it's super easy to get pitched forward and have yourself come out of your seat. I remember when I started taking riding lessons, one thing the instructor said to help you keep in mind to keep your shoulders back is think about someone grabbing you by the top of your helmet and pulling up. So it's then you're sitting up straight and your shoulders are back. So that's one thing you can think about to help visualize what that's supposed to look like. One reason a lot of people start bouncing out of the saddle when it comes to horseback riding is because they're off balance and they're trying to catch their balance back and they just can't. And so when you can assert that balance over the horse, it's going to be a lot more helpful with keeping yourself in the saddle. Alright, my second one is another easier fix. It's just really a posture issue and a position issue when riding your horse. Fixing this one issue can also improve your seat and help you be more balanced. And that is making sure you are bending your elbows when you're riding. So, elbows at your side and your thumbs up as you hold the reins is correct posture when it comes to horseback riding. Unfortunately, sometimes it's super easy to get straight arms and your thumbs are to the side and you're kind of like leaning on your horse's neck. That is one thing I personally have struggled with when it comes to horseback riding, and I'm sure many other people struggle with it as well. When your arms are straight and your arms are forward, it's easy. You're dropping your shoulders and then you're pitching yourself forward, so you're going to be out of the saddle, your weight's going to be over the horse's shoulders, and you're probably also going to be pinching with your knees. So not a good combination. But when you bend your elbows, you automatically kind of sit back, and then your shoulders are back because your elbows are at your side. And so then your center of balance is over the horse, but you're also like sitting back in the saddle. So one reason people keep their arms straight is because they feel like they're pulling on the horse's mouth. And so when you bend your elbows, you just are gonna need to loosen your reins. Sometimes your reins just may be too tight and you may be up in your horse's mouth too much if you have straight elbows. So by bending your elbows, you know, lengthening your reins a little bit, that actually may be more enjoyable for your horse. If you still feel like you're pulling on your horse's mouth with bent elbows, you can make sure your hands are following them, you know, just going with the movement of the horse. So a great exercise to practice keeping your elbows at your side is to take an object and put it in between your side and your elbow, and as you ride, you need to hold it there. So I actually took my dog's toy because I thought it was a good shape for this activity. And so I put it between my side and my elbow, and I rode around like that for a while, and it does really help you. You can feel that your shoulders are back, and it also helps with your hands. You know, the pressure on the reins is now going to be even because your arms are kind of at the starting point at your side, and so your hands will be in an even position when it comes to riding. So there's many benefits for bending your elbows when you ride, and it's also a correct position, so it's important that we do it, but it will also help you improve your seat and stay in the saddle. So here's another position issue that you may be dealing with. If you're having a hard time keeping yourself in the saddle and maybe you bounce around a little bit on your horse, is you have to make sure that your legs are staying under you. When you're horseback riding, and if you were to look at a picture, the correct position would draw a straight line from your head down through your hip and then down to the heel of your boot. And that's the correct position when horseback riding. You want your feet to be under you, and that's putting your weight under you instead of, you know, if your legs are going forward, that means your weight is back and you're not gonna really have a grip on what's going on, so you're probably gonna bounce around a lot. And if your legs are behind you, then you're getting pitched forward and your weight's getting thrown over the horse's shoulders, and it's gonna be really easy if they were to trip or stop at a jump, you're gonna fly over their head. So one reason it may be hard to keep your legs under you or keep your leg from swinging is because you're pinching with your knees. So I know it's super easy to start pinching with your knees, especially if you don't feel comfortable or confident on a horse. Your knees feel like they're your security. If you notice, when you pinch with your knees, that immediately leaves your bottom leg loose and it can just swing around and do whatever it wants. So it's important to learn what muscles you need to engage in order to ride correctly and have the right position. One body part you should not be using that much is your knees. Instead of pinching with your knees, you're gonna apply more pressure with your thighs. And this will keep you in the saddle. It's gonna make your seat more secure and keep you from bouncing. It's also gonna allow you to use your bottom leg for aids as well as keeping your bottom leg still. So one great exercise to try with this is to take a dollar bill or maybe another piece of paper, and you're gonna just stick it under your thigh, between your thigh and your saddle. And the goal is to ride around with this dollar and not let it fly out of your seat. So if you're pinching with your knees, chances are you're gonna lose the dollar as you ride. But if you're keeping your knees relaxed and you have connection at your thighs and at your lower leg, then you should be able to keep the dollar under your seat. So actually, around here where I grew up, at local shows, they always had a class. It was a bareback class, and you were to keep this dollar under your thigh. You know, if you dropped your dollar, you got disqualified and the money was left in the ring. So the last person left, who still had the dollar under their leg, would get all the money that was dropped by the other rider. So a little incentive for winning the class, along with a blue ribbon, but it's also a great way to practice you know, having the right position and also, you know, using your thighs more than your knees. All right, so let's actually get into some exercises you can start doing to help make yourself stronger, help yourself get in the right position, help yourself get more balanced on your horse. And this way, you're not gonna be bouncing around. So the next one may seem kind of silly once you see it, but I think it's really helpful, and it's just practicing standing up in your stirrups, you know, standing straight up. I remember when I first started taking riding lessons, when I was like 7 years old, the instructor would have us just stand straight up in our stirrups, even just at a standstill. And it was so hard to do, and it was because my core muscles weren't built up and I was really off balance on my horse. And so I found it difficult. But now I can, you know, walk, trot, canter around standing up in my stirrups, kind of looking silly. But it is really helpful in terms of like engaging those right muscles and also balancing yourself, and it will help your seat, surprisingly. But it will, because it's helping you gain that balance that you need to be able to stay securely on your horse rather than bouncing around. So in the beginning, if you're new to horseback riding, you're probably gonna find this really hard. You're just standing straight up, but you can use the pommel of your saddle or the horse's mane to help you just get up and start at a standstill and just practice standing maybe for a minute at a time. You're gonna feel your lower legs really start to burn. That's a good burn though. And you're also gonna feel your core engaged. And then from there, from the standstill, you can go to walk or trot or canter and just practice keeping yourself up out of your saddle. A great game you can play with this is have a few other riders, and I'll stand up and be doing things, but whoever's bottom touches the saddle first loses. This is kind of a sub point of practice standing up in your stirrups, but it's also, you can practice your 2-point. So your 2-point is like your jump position or your half seat. It's where you're gonna kind of bring your chest down and your hands up, but you're still gonna keep your shoulders back and you're still gonna keep your weight over the center of the horse. This is a more forward seat, but it also helps, you know, when you run your 2-point, you're gonna feel your legs burning. But it's also gonna help you figure out balance over your horse. So just because your chest is forward doesn't mean that you have to be off balance. I try to work in my 2-point a few minutes each time I ride just so I can improve myself and improve my position. So my other point is a little bit more unenjoyable, and it is building those muscles that you're gonna need to improve your seat and to improve your position and everything like that when it comes to horseback riding. I'm not a fan of working out, but I know it's important, especially if I want to be a better horseback rider. So some areas to focus on if you plan on working out for horseback riding is your core. That is a big one. So your balance comes from your core, and if you have a stronger core, then you're going to have better balance and you're going to have a good seat. Because if you're using your seat and you're keeping your bottom in the saddle and you have a driving seat, you'll notice that your core is engaged when you do that. It's an ab workout. Another area you can focus on is the lower leg. So if you ride standing up in your stirrups or in your two-point position, like the points we just mentioned, you'll notice that your lower legs are gonna burn really bad. And so working them out outside of horseback riding will help increase the stamina of that muscle so you can do that longer. And it will also help you keep your lower leg under you. Another great muscle to work out are your thighs. Just because if you're using your seat, you're gonna be using your thighs a lot because you're driving your seat forward and that movement comes from your hip and your thighs. And so that will help you out a lot. You can also, when it comes to working out for horseback riding, you can work out your arms, not so that you can pull on your horse's face better, but just so you have that control and that strength you need in handling horses, just in general, even on the ground. If your horse is kind of freaking out on the ground, you need the strength to be able to hold them and control them. So having arm muscles is a big part of horseback riding, and if you're riding horses that tend to get strong or heavy, having arm muscles can be beneficial. You can rock them back and use your lower leg to encourage them to use their hind end. So things like that are important to think about when it comes to working out for horseback riding. But your main goal should be, if you have trouble keeping your seat in the saddle, is working out those muscles that are gonna benefit you to help you balance and keep yourself in your saddle. So the biggest one is probably your core. So the next few points are gonna be very similar to the bareback video we just did. This is largely because when you ride bareback, you're gonna be using your seat a lot more. And if you're bouncing around bareback, you're probably gonna fall off. If you wanna check that video out, I'll put the link in the description. All right, so my first point for this section is to practice moving your seat with the motion of the horse. Think about the sitting trot. If you do the sitting trot and you have a hard time keeping your seat in the saddle and you just feel like you're getting jostled, this is probably because you're not moving your seat with the movement of the horse. So you can start this at the walk, and what you're gonna do is you're just gonna start swinging your hips with the motion of the horse. And you don't have to swing your hips unnaturally or anything like that. All you have to do is let your hips go with the movement of the horse. So at the walk, you'll notice that your hips are gonna swing more side to side, while at the trot, it's gonna be more up and down. And then you'll notice at the canter, you're gonna be pushing your seat forward as if you're driving your horse up into the bit. So when you're able to move with the movement of your horse, then you can start using aids with your seat and signaling your horse to do things. So if you slow your seat down, your horse is gonna slow down. If you speed your seat up and you're purposefully driving the horse forward, that horse is gonna move out a lot more. So being able to use your seat like this is really beneficial. So it's just important that you're gonna learn to go with the horse rather than fighting the horse. So when you're not moving your seat, you're fighting that movement. So if your horse has a hard time cantering or moving forward or anything like that, it may be because your seat is kind of blocking them from doing that. So I mentioned this in the previous point, but I'll just go over this again so you guys can hear it. And it is find the rhythm of the horse's gait. So if I know that a walk is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and with my seat it's gonna go side to side, then it's gonna be a lot easier for me to find that rhythm and sit securely in my saddle. Rather than if I don't know really what's going on and I just feel bouncing, then I'm just gonna bounce in my saddle, right? So you can practice finding the rhythm of the horse's gait. You can practice hearing every step that the horse is taking. So if it's a walk, you'll hear the 1, 2, 3, 4, and you'll feel their hind end swing. If you're trotting, you'll hear the beat, the 1, 2, 1, 2, and you'll feel yourself going, it's more of an up and down motion. And then at the canter, if you listen, it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and you can feel yourself swinging the way the horse is moving. So just being able to take time and focus on those things, even though they're so slight. But if you can teach yourself to focus and hear and recognize the rhythm of your horse's gaits, it's gonna make you in tune with the horse and it's gonna make you a much better rider. All right, another point I have to help improve your seat is to ride bareback. So we had mentioned this before, but riding bareback is going to improve your seat by 1,000 times. I rode bareback a lot. I was that kid who would just get to the barn and put a halter on their horse and go jump around the ring And it was because I did not want to tack up. I was so lazy. But it really helped to establish my seat and to establish the proper muscles I needed to have a good seat. And I'd like to think that I have good stickability when it comes to horseback riding. Like, it's hard for me to fall off. And that could be because I've been riding for years, but I really do think it's because I rode bareback a lot. And the horses I had back then weren't necessarily, you know, just go around the ring ponies. Like, they spooked and would freak out sometimes. So it really taught me to use my seat well and to stay on my horse. And when you can do that and like stick to your horse no matter what's happening, that means that you have a good seat. Like, you've solidified in that, you're not coming off that horse. So riding bareback, and I'm not saying like riding bareback you're gonna fall off, but just because it takes away the constraints that you're used to when you're riding a saddle. So you don't have stirrups to rely on anymore, or the security of a saddle where it's wrapped around your legs and your seat, and so it's holding you there kind of. Now it's just you and your horse. So you have to learn to use your seat appropriately, or you're gonna be bouncing around on your horse. It's gonna be super uncomfortable. All right, and my last point for all of this to improve your seat is to remember to breathe. I don't know if y'all have noticed that, but sometimes I'll do a jump course or something and I'll be worked up, and then I'll finish the course and I'll come back and I'll notice I'm so out of breath, like I held my breath for that entire course. So when you hold your breath, you naturally get tense. And if you notice, if you're tense, you're naturally breathing a little bit more rapidly. And so when you focus on just breathing deep, no matter what your horse is doing, that kind of automatically makes you sit back and put weight into your seat. So that's just a good thing to remember. It's something that you like subconsciously do, but it will help keep yourself in your saddle and also keep yourself calm. So I've noticed that like some horses are getting worked up, the rider's naturally getting tense, and then if the horse is to do something crazy, they're probably gonna fall off because they're gripping with their knees, they're leaning forward, they're jerking on the reins. Compared to when you relax, you're breathing deep, you're just chilling, that horse doesn't see much to get freaked out about. And so then that will help them relax and things like that too. If you think about it, a horse can feel like a small fly landing on them. So they can feel, you know, really subtle things. So as you sit on your horse can probably feel your heartbeat and they can probably feel how you're breathing. So when they feel your breath quickening, that's a sign of anxiety and adrenaline and stuff like that. And if they can feel your heart beating faster, the same thing. And so they're naturally gonna start breathing faster and their adrenaline's naturally gonna start going up. So when you can control your breathing, and just keep it nice and chill and calm, the horse will notice that, you know, your heartbeat's normal, your breathing's normal, so there's nothing that they have to be afraid of. So, just another tidbit of information to know, but it is important to be able to control your breathing on a horse, and that will also help improve your seat. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and go subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time.